Two of the greatest walleye fisheries in North America are mighty tributary rivers of Manitoba's massive Lake Winnipeg. The Winnipeg River starts its journey from the northern portion of Lake of the Woods at Kenora, winding its way through rugged Canadian Shield country to enter Lake Winnipeg near Pine Falls, Manitoba. In contrast, the Red River makes long passage from the south through flat farmland that once was the southern basin of ancient Lake Agassiz, entering the Big Lake after flowing through Manitoba's capital city, Winnipeg. The final sections of these rivers and Lake Winnipeg are the home of the greenback walleye, one of the most uniquely colored walleyes in all of North America. Lake Winnipeg itself, no surprise, also is a tremendous walleye fishery, especially during winter, when thousands of anglers flock to ice to fish the shallow southern basin. Plenty of smaller walleye satisfy anglers wanting a meal of fresh fish, but the real draw is the chance to catch giants surpassing 10 pounds and perhaps up to 15. Indeed, if the fish are there, people will come. The Red River, and to a lesser extent, the Winnipeg River, also are home to the world's greatest fishing for channel catfish. Now, there just aren't lots of fish. They average larger than anywhere else in North America. On a good day, anglers can reasonably expect to catch 20 channel catfish, with many, or most, surpassing 20 pounds. The fishing isn't just world class, it's an international treasure. But we're here to look at a typical day on the water during fall, once the greenbacks from Lake Winnipeg have pushed into the rivers. This trip is on the lower Red, not far from where it enters Lake Winnipeg.
That is a thick Lake Winnipeg greenback walleye.
Right there, man. Good job.
Wow. What do you figure, 10?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that's 10. That's 30-inch fish right there.
Wow.
Beautiful.
Gorgeous.
So, great start to the day. The fishing at this time of year, we're here the second week of October. We've got a little weather moving in. We've got rain, a little sleet. So, tough kind of day, but we are started. And the greenback Nomer comes from that emerald, almost chartreuse green.
Iridescent green.
Iridescent green that these walleyes take on the Red River here.
Yeah. You get the coloring from the North Basin, the limestone-rich content in the North Basin, and that's what they get this unique coloring from.
So we're here to talk about the Red River and the sister river, really the Winnipeg. And this river, when we always talk about when the fish are here, people will come. Well, you get that with the catfish here on the Red, which is one of the greatest fisheries in the entire universe. And then in the fall and in the winter, this is what fuels thousands and thousands of people coming to the river to catch these fish. And then on the Big Lake during the wintertime.
No, absolutely. I call it the 1-2 punch of Manitoba trophy fishing, eh? The catfish, and then you got these giant Lake Winnipeg greenback walleyes that are, you know, they're commercially fished throughout the year, but it's just massive pods of these fish. And yeah, just incredible, incredible opportunity.
Yeah, and of course the lake is, Lake Winnipeg is one of the largest lakes in the entire world, so.
It is. 10th largest freshwater lake in the world, I believe.
All right, so. Well, catch and release, so okay. Let's let him go.
Let's go. They seem to be just picking it up just off bottom. Oh, there we go.
Oh, that's good.
Oh, yeah, this is
there
a good
go.
One. Another good one. Here she comes, here she
no,
comes.
No, not bad. There
oh,
we go.
Oh, look at that, another thick.
Not as big as that last one, but nice. Nice job, Donovan.
Good job, buddy.
Woo! You're hot. Let's get him in here.
Oh.
Have a look. Huh. Beautiful fish again, Donovan.
Great fish.
See, oh, my jig fell out. Got him in the hand here. One of your patented jigs.
Yeah.
Here we are.
On
nice
a greenback slammer.
Not as big as that last one, but this one's 27 inches, but kind of skinny.
Yeah, a little bit.
Here, have a look.
Look at that. Beautiful fish.
And look at how big the eyes are. Incredible.
Yeah, just thick, eh?
Yeah.
Thick through the back, green coloring from the lake.
And it's a very cool situation because, you know, someone like me comes to the Red River and I'm predisposed to want to be crankbaiting in this kind of water or maybe pull and swim baits, my favorite. And it just doesn't work that well, does it?
No, it doesn't. You know, it was a tough lesson for me to learn years ago coming from Lake of the Woods too, where, you know, you move around and you want to stay moving, drifting, keep moving, aggressive tactics, pulling cranks, and 9 times out of 10, you got to just stay still, anchored still, keep your jig on bottom, maintaining contact, maybe just up a bit, and that's what these fish are. They want to key in on it, sniff it, get a, you know, and then pull it off bottom half the time. So,
wow. Yeah. Well, we're gonna let you show them exactly how it's done here. So we put this one back.
Okay, for sure.
Down you go.
Okay, well, I prefer these long shank jigs just to get the big minnows. You want big presentation, this dark, dirty water. I got these greenback slammer jigs on here. And what I try to do is, this is the way I've always done it. If I'm gonna put two minnows on the hook, I'll go through the mouth, out the gills like that, and I wanna slide this all the way up to the head.
Yep.
But I find the second minnow just adds more bulk to it, easier for the fish to see. And I'll put that through like that, and then I'll just kinda attach that one with the tail of the other minnow. And quite often you can just catch fish like that, but we do use stinger hooks here. It just even if it means one big fish during the day, it's worth using it. So I'll take a stinger on there, put it on like that, and basically that's a presentation, just a big glob of minnows there. 70% of the time, we're just letting the jig sit on bottom. We're not moving it, not jigging it, just letting it sit there. And then sometimes they want a little bit more aggressive and jigging it, and basically slow lifts and drops, and quite often just lifting it up an inch or two off bottom and holding it off bottom will be what's triggering the bites that day. So you definitely, it's definitely a place where less is more.
You've got spots up by Selkirk to get people fish. We're down by Netley Creek.
There's lots of community spots. They're all good. This is where you want to fish them. These fish are not resident. They're migrational. They're moving in, they're moving through. So you just want to set yourself up on a good kind of ambush spot. We're usually targeting 11 to 14 feet on the edge of a channel.
Wait for the fish to come through.
So there you have it. Unbelievable fishing for channel catfish. Some of the finest ice fishing for giant walleyes in all of North America. And once fall rolls around, world-class fishing for giant walleyes on the Red and Winnipeg rivers. This area near Winnipeg, Manitoba is an urban fishery at its finest. One of the greatest fishing destinations in the world.
But look at this fish, the high dorsal fin. The beautiful color, the gigantic eyes, and as you say, these fish are growing fast and fat.
Yeah, absolutely. What's not to love about Manitoba?
I don't know. It doesn't get any better than this, man.